slide up.
Three hours later.
We are approximately 16 weeks out from the WBFF LA Pro-Am show. I'm currently putting in place the foundations of my prep, and it's at this point, around 16 weeks out, that I really need to start tightening the screws. So today, time to get serious, time to train legs.
Yeah, buddy! Wait, wait!
Last warm-up set here, 180 kilos. Using the belt now. The first couple of warm-up sets, bracing without the belt, just getting into the rhythm, the pattern. You start from the barbell and you move all the way up towards your working weight. Key, whether you're warming up with just the barbell or whether you're warming up with 180 kilograms, is to rehearse the same cues that you do during your working set. Every set should look the exact same. 200, for as many as I possibly can.
That was nuts.
So next exercise, leg press, doing with the narrow stance. So feet practically together, coming down. I just think with the leg press, it's one of those exercises where you can potentially fall into the trap of putting too much weight on there. I like to go through a full range of motion with this exercise. The narrow stance, targeting the vastus lateralis. So the outer quad sweep is something that I've been really focusing on. It's a common trend or consistency every time I address leg training on video. It's because if I can develop the outer quad sweep, it will create the illusion that my legs are larger than they actually are. So when you step on stage, you need to factor in that bodybuilding, physique development, physique competitions are all about creating the illusion on stage that you're bigger than you actually are. So that you can focus on proportions, focusing on delt development. If you can build up your shoulders, have width in your legs to create that X taper, what it can do is make you appear larger than you actually are. Third exercise on today's program is the dumbbell Romanian deadlift. Now for the last couple of weeks I've been alternating between the barbell variation of this exercise and the dumbbell variation. Today I'm choosing lighter loads, using higher rep schemes and a more deliberate eccentric phase to really stretch the hamstring out, isolate it, and then try to fire up explosively with each repetition. So one of the things I find with the Romanian deadlift, comparable to your conventional deadlift, is the slight knee bend, but then it remains in that fixed position as you perform each rep. There is a tendency that if the weight is too heavy, that suddenly bend the knee and engage too much quad. So once it's in that fixed position, it does not move. The hamstrings are one of my weaker muscle groups, so I'm prioritising them in this particular program. I'm very fortunate that I've got a single leg hamstring curl. It's standing hamstring curl machine here. I think when it comes to this exercise or any hamstring curling movement, there's the tendency to rely on momentum to bring the weight up. And one thing I'm really consciously trying to do is pressing my hips against the pad as I curl up so that all the tension is placed through my hamstrings. There's a tendency, and I do it all the time, and I need to discipline myself to not take my hips off the pad. They need to be at full extension, and I need to rise up. I might have limited range of motion, but it's a whole lot better than relying on momentum. Final quad exercise is actually going to be a superset. We're going to do a bit of metabolite work. I'm going to start off with an isolation exercise, leg extension, and then I'm going to immediately move into a kettlebell goblet squat. With the goblet squats, I'm going to be looking at doing a very slow eccentric phase and focusing on pump. We're doing an isolation, a pre-exhaustion before moving on to the compound movement with the kettlebell goblet squat. Key with this exercise, simply to deliberately slow down the eccentric portion and be willing to accept the flamethrower that is being applied to your quadriceps. Having the discipline to go through each repetition with controlled form. You'll notice I'm not having a break at the top of each rep. It's just continuous. All right, so I'm gonna finish this leg workout with 5 sets of calf press. Now, over the last 12 to 18 months, I've been prioritizing calf development, and I've found that the best way in order to increase the size of your calves is by increasing the frequency with which you train them. So when performing any calf raise or pressing movement, it's really important to focus on the stretch at the bottom of each repetition before consciously contracting the calf and squeezing at the top of each repetition. One of the things I find is that often, because calves are placed towards the back end of the leg section when you're already under fatigue, we often lose focus and we allow momentum and our Achilles tendon to effectively take over the lift. So rather than bouncing through each repetition, what I would implore you to do is really concentrate, focus on the squeeze, the top of the movement, to ensure that you're actually training your calves and not any other muscle group. Slow, 2, 1, stretch, contract.
Does foot position have a difference?
Foot position, you can play around with foot position. You could do toes pointed in, you could do toes pointed out to target various areas of your calves, whether it's the outer or the inner. Having said that, I really do think that, you know, changing of angle and foot position is one thing, but you should be more focused on the principles of controlled repetitions over angles necessarily. In the end, irrespective of whether your toes are in or out, your whole calf is going to get worked regardless.
I did a good session.
Yeah, it was a good session. I think the AMRAP test went well. I was pleasantly surprised with that. The accessory work went well as well. I think, yeah, all in all, a good start to the prep. Leg days are always arduous, it's always taxing, and yes, that's the most rewarding part about walking in apprehensive and then walking out feeling triumphant.
Triumphant. Give us a sign off. We need a sign off.
What do you want to say?
Ready, 3, quick, anything. Ready, 3, 2, 1, just do something. 3, 2, 1. No, you're supposed to do something.
What am I meant to do?
Just anything.
I don't do dabs.
Oh, okay. First thing that comes to your head. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Yes.
Yes.